Hi, and welcome to another GrandMA3 tutorial on the Event Lighting channel. This time we're going to talk about GrandMA3 presets. Presets are the building blocks like Lego pieces we stitch together when we build the sequences, and we basically build our show. And you can store presets in a few different ways. You can store them as a selective preset, you can store them as a global preset, and you can store them as a universal preset. And you can actually combine those three things as well. So I'm going to show you how you switch between them, and if you stick around to the end, we're going to use them on a few phase effects as well. So that's going to help you if you want to introduce new fixtures into a show and you use recipes or you want to make it simple on yourself. So welcome to this week's tutorial. Let's get into it. So as you can see, I loaded the same show we used last time when we did all the color bump and recipe stuff, and I did a little cleaning up in here. But right here you can see all the different presets we used last time and some new ones as well. You can see the dimmer here has a small U up here and the same does color. Down here in the position we have a small U and we have an S. And the U stands for universal, the S stands for selective, and now I'll show you how to control what you store and how you store it. So if we select all our asterisks, let's build a simple position. I'll just touch the pan and tilt down here so we have some information in the programmer. And then we go into our store key here and we store that into the position preset up here. And as you can see, there's a small S here, which means it is a selective preset. And what does selective mean? Selective mean that it depends on a special selection of fixtures. In this case, we selected all our asterisks. So if we clear this and try to build a new one, we might be able to select them up here and select only 5 of them. And once again, we touch the position just a little bit. As you can see, there's only 5 active right now. So if I store this into a preset, it's still a selective preset, but this time it only contains, the 6 Astra fixtures in here. So a selective preset stores the selection of whatever your fixture count was. So that is basically what a selective preset is. Just a small interruption for our online school. We're going to start a new online school with the GrandMA3 content and network switches and all stuff like that. If you are interested in that, there's a link for an email list down in the description. I hope you will sign up. You can sign out anytime, so hope to see you there. Let's continue. But how can you decide which one you want to store? In this case, we stored selective, and why did the console automatically store a selective preset? Well, you can go in here in the command section, you can go down to the store button, and you can press and hold the store button, and you will see this box appear. And in here we have a lot of different options, which we'll get into in other tutorials, and we have already covered some of them. But the thing we're looking for here is down here the preset mode. The preset mode is right now selective. And if we right click on the preset mode here, you can see the different options we have. So if we try to set it into global, it's gonna prefer to store a global preset from now on. And what I can do is I can save the preference up here. If I save the preference, as we did the change right now, it's gonna use all these settings right now. The programmer will be active, MATrix will be active, input filter will be active if I save the preference. And it's gonna save the preference on the global one as well. So if we exit this and we try it again and say we want to make a global preset. So what is a global preset? You can, in this case, select only one fixture of one specific type. In this case, we still use the Astra 600 IP fixture and we selected only one of them. So let's try to go into the color section here and just touch a simple color here and make it a cyan kind of color. If I store this into my color pool here, you can see it's a global preset. And global preset will work on any of the fixtures of the same type. Right now, we only selected one fixture and we changed one color. But if I take all my Astras now and select all of them, and hence this is a global preset, I can press it and it's going to work on all of them. And even if I patch more fixtures of the same type, a global preset will still work on all of them. And that can help you if you are building your show with recipes and you introduce new fixtures into the show, like we did in the last tutorial. And if you didn't watch that, you can click the link up here in the corner, and that's going to take you to the video from last week. And by the way, you can join our Discord community if you click the link down in the description. There's a lot of cool people in there. There's a lot of questions being answered. It's a really cool place to be. So I hope to see you in there. So that's basically a global preset. A global preset works on the fixture type you used to create it. The last one we have is a universal preset. And a universal preset works on all fixtures, no matter what kind of fixture it is, as long as it has that kind of parameter like you used to save it. In this case, we used RGB down here. So if you select any other or patch any other fixture that has RGB color mixing system, then you can store that as a universal preset and it's still gonna work. And as you can see up here, these ones are universal. But let's just try to delete this one here and let's clear the console. And once again, we simply select only one of the asterisks. We do the same thing again. We change the color down to just a simple cyan color. And we go into our command section. We press and hold the store button and we right click the preset mode and we go down to universal and we save the preference. So now if we store something, it's gonna prefer to be a universal preset. So let's store this up here in the color preset. You can see it's stored a fixture. We clear this and we once again select all our asterisks and we press this one and it works on all of them. And the cool part is we didn't even touch the vipers. But if I touch the vipers and I turn them on and put them into some sort of position and I use my universal preset, they're also gonna work here. So again, if you are trying to build some kind of a show where you want to introduce new fixtures all the time and you want to use recipes like we did in the last episode, a universal preset is preferable because then you can simply patch a new fixture and everything is going to work on its own. And that is really, really cool. You can also use this on effects or phaser effects. So if we clear this, and you can see there's a small U up here once again, if we take all our asterisks and we put them into a circle of some sort, and we store this into another position, you can see there's a small U up here. And what you can do in this case here, you can go in and you can do all kinds of MA tricks in here. You can give it a wing of 2 and you can face it from 0 to 360, for instance. And we clear this. And now you can see it works here. And again, if you introduce another fixture, we can try it again with the vipers. We take the vipers, we put them at 100 in a position with a narrow zoom, and we put it into this preset here. It's going to work. Even though it's grayed out, it's still going to work, which is really, really, really cool. So that is basically the functions of presets and the different ways you can go about using presets in your GrandMA3 show. If you got any value out of this video, be sure to give it a like. That's going to indicate to YouTube that it spreads it out to more people. And if you want to learn more about GrandMA3, watch this video next. It's going to teach you more about GrandMA3 and some other functionality, and we're going to dig into other stuff. Until I see you next time, I hope you enjoyed the video, of course, and I hope you have some fantastic GrandMA3 programming sessions. See ya.